the award, or the Wilkes Awards, which are the top awards you can get in computer architecture, being fellows of the UCM and actually professional societies, as well as the National Academy of Engineers. And myself, I got the runner-up for the TCCACCA Sigurd Hussain Dissertation Award. So we have a strong track record of success in driving our students to achieve success in many different areas, as well as having quite a bit of a few outstanding grad students around, which we'd love to have you come to those programs. And our students, once they graduate, they go on to achieve lots of success elsewhere too. So we have over a dozen former graduate students, PhD students, who've gone on to academia at many different places, both within the US as well as around the globe. Places like Uppsala in Sweden, IISc in India, as well as ETFL, which is missing from the slide, but is another top university in Europe. So our students go on to achieve lots of success and have their own great research groups elsewhere. And those of you who might prefer to go into industry, we have top people at basically every research lab and company you might want to go work with. People at AMD and Cray and Cavium and Google, Qualcomm, Microsoft, the list goes on and on. And a lot of these people have been the principal architects behind many of the major chips that have been designed in our community. For example, the Google Tensor Processing Unit, which a few of you might know about, has come out in the past year or so. And some of our alum had a major role in crafting the design of that chip, as well as many of the other ones in the companies like ours. And hopefully what you've taken is, in addition to this track record of success, we also have a very strong current and future where papers being selected as the top papers in computer architecture every year, roughly 20% of those have been from our students and in our faculty. And ISCA, which is the top conference for computer architecture, we've had 10 papers there over the past 3 years with similar numbers in all of the other top conferences. And of course, like I said, we'd love for you to come and join us and add your name to these various schools. Alright, so if there remaining time, let me briefly touch on a couple of the projects that the faculty that I mentioned in earlier slides are working on. And of course, as I'm sure you've heard a few times already, please feel free to reach out to us or talk to others to schedule meetings if we're not already on the course. Professor Hill runs the multifaceted research group, and what they're looking at is multi-core energy design, and the way that that's manifested itself in people like Patricia in recent years is looking at things like virtual memory and system. How we design systems and hardware for those. And moving forward, what that group is looking at, they're headed to systems, continuing on system memory, and looking at how to make those systems more efficient, as well as looking at how we can address some of the fundamental security problems that have recently come up through issues like Spectre and Mountain. Curry Sanferlingo leads the vertical research group, and what they're focused on is technology-driven architecture. So looking at things like programmable accelerators and extreme data flow acceleration, figuring out how we can get extreme energy efficiency while also getting really good performance. Professor Sohi leads the multi-scalar research group, which in the past has focused on fundamental concepts like speculative multi-threading and invariants that are used widely across the community and industry today. And what he's been working on more recently and moving forward is looking at non-traditional like I said, is one of the really interesting and important directions that I'm moving in and trying to figure out how we can effectively program them and give good efficiency. And Professor Lee leads the Wickley Lab, where she is focused on reconfigurable architectures. So the idea here is how can we design both general purpose and domain-specific accelerators to get good performance and energy efficiency for a wide range. And this involves things like algorithmic co-design with the architecture, as well as looking at prototyping the actual chips that might exist in the future to run these things. Professor Lapasti runs the farm research group, and a lot of the work they do is focused on system and processor design, including things like novel and power-efficient cache coherence interconnects. As well as something that I think is really cool, this group has also been looking at non-fundamental biological computing systems. For example, looking at how they can design computing systems that model the human brain, which is something that hasn't been receiving as much attention in the community, but is something that I think is extremely impactful and really useful. Myself, I run the HAL, or Energy and Use Architectures Group, and what we're focusing on are optimizations and energy systems. And the way that's manifested itself in recent years is things like better coherence and better consistency in data organization and systems. And what I'm doing moving forward is what I like to call application difference, where we look at applications that don't necessarily run well on modern architectures and look at what we can do to make them more efficient through optimizing things holistically, including the hardware and the software and the algorithms for those applications. And last but not least, Professor San Miguel is focused on energy-centric computing. And this manifests itself in many different ways, but one way is looking at proximal computing and how we can take that idea from circuits all the way up to the programming languages that Justin's going to tell you a bit about. And this involves looking at really low-power systems that do things like energy harvesting and intermittent computing, which present really interesting new paradigms that a lot of traditional systems do not necessarily consider. Okay, so to wrap up, I just wanted to point out we have a website, which you are, of course, welcome to go to, that touches on this information in a lot more detail if you're interested. As you heard from many of the other groups, our students will be available as well to meet with you from 3 to 5 in 7331 CS. And all of us will be around, so if you're not already scheduled to meet with us, please feel free to reach out either during the meals or by talking to each other just to get added to our members. Thank you all for listening, and I hope to get to talk with you more later today.